Welcome to Rivet City. Please wait while the bridge extends.
Hold it right there. State your business in Rivet City. Yeah? Let me guess. No, she's not expecting you. But it's really important, and you need to see her right away. Been a lot of that going around lately, and I've had just about enough of it. So you're going to have to do better than that. Older guy, in his 50s or so? I remember him. He left already, but Dr. Lee might know more. All right, you can go on up. She'll be in the science lab. Just don't cause any trouble, or else you're gonna answer to me. Are those rumors still floating around? Look, I don't have time for swapping ghost stories with you. Pinkerton's a legend. Dead or long gone. Don't care much, as I've got real people to take care of. Go bother someone else. I don't exactly have time to worry about the history around here, now do I? I've got to worry about what's happening on it now. I suppose. It doesn't work like that. I'm in charge of security. Dr. Lee runs most of everything else. Bannon kinda represents the merchants. He also owns Potomac Attire. She's one of the members of the council. Runs the science lab here. Don't bother her unless it's important. Her lab is in the stern end of the ship. We're the safest, most secure city in the wasteland. Nothing can get in here without our say-so. Carry on, then.
I'm on duty. Make it quick. Don't you believe the rumors? His ghost is certainly not haunting the bow of this ship. Now, if you'll excuse me, I have work to do. She's some sort of genius, you know, one of those egghead scientist types. Her lab is in the stern end of the ship. Oh, really? If someone took your stuff, go get it back. If they shoot at you, shoot back. Otherwise, I've got to see it for myself before I'm gonna do anything. Later.
Let me or a security officer know if you see anything out of the ordinary.
Don't tell me your problems. Hello? Don't tell me your problems.
What do you have?
Beer. And don't let it get empty.
They call me Sister. Don't ask. Are you making fun of my name? It's a damn good thing for you. This place is crawling with security. Otherwise, I'd kick your ass. You're bothering me. Do I look like someone who cares? So do I.
I'm Flak. If you want a decent weapon, stop by Flak and Shrapnel's. I'm sure that was just luck. You should upgrade. Check out our shop in the market. You mean Genius Boy? Yeah, I've heard of him. Supposedly built Rivet City. They probably think he invented bread too. Idiots. Lately, he's even been blamed for the noises in the broken ship bow. Anyone with half a brain would know that's just the Mire Lurks. Fred, I can't help you, pal. Been here for years, but all I know about the history is that it's a safe place to settle down. Maybe Bannon can help you out. He sure acts like he knows it all. Later.
Hey, stranger.
Hey, good-looking. How come you haven't bought me a drink yet? Now that's what I like in a man. Enough caps to buy a lady a drink. Can't help you with the history, honey. It's noisy, dark, and smelly. But we're safe here. No super mutants or raiders. And maybe Dr. Lee will find a way to get clean water for us. You're lost, sugar. Come and see me again sometime.
I am Father Clifford of St. Monica's Church. She is the patron saint of lost children, very popular among the faithful of Rivet City. I'm surprised you've never heard of her. If you want to hear her story, it will be the topic of my sermon on Sunday. Services begin at 8 a.m. You should come. Yes, my flock is all of Rivet City. You should come to services this Sunday. I'll be telling the tale of St. Monica. Oh, it's not the past of the city that I dwell upon, but the future of its inhabitants. But if you're interested, I believe Miss Weatherly or Mr. Bannon would be glad to speak with you on the subject. St. Monica bless you. It's locked for a reason. Don't get any ideas. Trini, can't you see what whiskey has done to your life? Yeah, you've sold your body to men and your soul to the devil.
Ship's water isn't much better.
I prefer beer.
You'll get fresh water soon.
And unless you want to buy me the next round, get lost. Mm.
I'm Belle Bonnie. And this is the Muddy Rudder. I'll tell you what I tell all the fresh meat. Don't start anything down here, or I'll have Brock kick your ass. You must be drunk. Are you gonna order or what? What a moron. Always going on about how he started Rivet City. Who gives a crap? Right before he disappeared, he was going on about some newfangled contraption he was sure was in the broken bow of the ship. Go talk to Vera if you want gossip. I don't talk bad about folks. History? What, not enough shit around here already? You need to dig up more? Don't know if it ever had an official start. It's just been here forever. Stuck in the river and full of assholes. No, I can't fucking well share one. What sort of moron are you? But fine. It'll get you out of my face. Go down to Pinkerton's shed in the broken-off bow of the ship. If he decides to give you a history lesson, it's no business of mine. Now get the hell out of my bar.
I heard that the city council was debating putting railings on the flight deck.
Well, I hope they do something. Remember the child? child that fell off the deck last year?
Yeah, that was bad. I'm sure they'll do something about it.
I've heard enough tonight.
It was so noisy last night. I could hardly sleep.
Maybe a quick fix is something that will help you sleep. Cindy's got all...
Hey!
Evening. I'm on duty. Make it quick. Chief Harkness meets with Dr. Lee and Bannon to discuss security matters. It's a waste of a good Monday morning, if you ask me. They should just let Chief Harkness call the shots. Yeah.
Away from me. What do you want? Are you one of them? I suppose it doesn't matter if I tell you. I used to be a slave. I saw a slaver on this ship. His name is Sister. I'm afraid he's after me. Really? Oh, thank you. Can you help me? I've been so worried with him around. I can hardly sleep at night. Thank you. I'll go to Flak and Shrapnel's just before closing. I don't have anything to give you, but I think I can trust you with a secret. If you ever go up north, there is a secret slave hideout called Temple of the Union. You might find them useful.
Okay. What do you want? My mom is probably drunk, and my dad's dead. Is that good enough for you, asshole?
Ted Strayer, you can chill with me if you want, dude. You mean, like, fix stuff? Nah. I just hang out, dude. I've got enough chems to last a while. Oh, yeah. Whoa, that's a blast from the past. My dad knew a dude named Crowley. I never met him, though. I think Dad said he died when they were checking out some old fort. Nah, he said that old man Tenpenny hired him and some other guys to go in there, but he never said why. My dad made enough caps off it to set him up good, though. Everybody knows he runs Tenpenny Tower, but I never met the dude. I swear. No shit. That dude wants me dead? Whoa. Is this, like, worth caps? 'Cause I got needs, man. No way, dude. Like I said, I need the caps. Oh yeah, I'm gonna be flying high tonight.
Hello.
Yeah? What do you want? Yeah, that's James. My own little troublemaking brat. I'd sell him to you if they'd let me. Unless you've got any more personal questions, I'm busy. Yeah? What do you want? Oh, really? My husband ran off and got himself killed and left me to raise his little brat. So don't you tell me how I should or shouldn't be.
Evening! Haven't run into you before. You probably wouldn't remember me anyway. I'm Mr. Lopez. Nobody does. I'm not very memorable. Don't worry, it won't be a problem for much longer. Just leave me alone.
So, dude, did that key ever get you anything?
It's locked for a reason. Don't get any ideas.
I'm Gary. Gary Staley. If you ever get hungry, stop by Gary's Galley. Perfect timing, then. My galley is in the market at the far end. I'll save you some Meyerlurk cakes. I know a lot of places opened up when they got the hydroponics bay working, but that's hardly the start of it all, is it? Actually, Vera Weatherly might know more. She's always here and talking with folks, so if anyone's picked up a story or two, it'd be her. Yeah, see ya.
Have you seen my husband, Polly?
I'm Cindy. I mean, Cindy Cantelli. I have a quick fix. I mean, I run a quick fix. Anyway, you were saying?
Yeah, Polly and I. Our shop is in the market. Boy, that sounded dumb. Where else would our shop be? Anyway, thanks. For being nice, that is.
Well, I don't really know, to tell the truth. How does any city get started, really? But I've heard Bannon talk about how he was responsible for its success. So I'd ask him about it. Bye!
Some sort of battle in the city yesterday. The gate guard said the gunfire went on for over an hour.
That's why I'm glad I'm in here. Good old Rivet City.
Me too. Nothing is getting through these walls. Hey.
Hey there.
Who are you? Got any psycho? I could really use a fix, but I'm broke. I run the chem shop, but I'm broke and can't buy chems. That's what Cindy says too, but I got the itch. I need it bad. Huh? History? What history? There's no history here, man. It's a place to live, safe from raiders and super mutants. With Dr. Lee on our side, maybe we can even begin to rebuild the world. Yeah, me too.
Oh, it's you. I mean, hi there. He's hopeless. I have to keep him away from the shop, or he'll rob us blind. One of these days, he's going to end up dead. Yeah, see ya. I really hope you're not thinking of breaking into there.
For the most advanced scientific setup.
I'm Janice Kaplinski, Chief Botanist. What do you need? If it hasn't got to do with the science quarters, I'm probably not the one to ask. And Dr. Lee's so busy, you really shouldn't disturb her work. I did see a man talking to Dr. Lee, but I really shouldn't be discussing it. She's already in a bad mood. I'd hate to make it worse. You should probably just talk to her about it. So long.
What's at stake?
Look, this is a restricted area. I'm tired of telling you people. It's you. My heavens, you look so much like him. You're James's son, aren't you? What are you doing here? Well, yes, of course I do. Don't you know who I am? I suppose James never told you. Typical. I'm Dr. Madison Lee. I worked with your father many years ago. Your mother as well, in fact. You'll have to forgive me. This has all been very stressful. What with your father suddenly showing up here after being gone for so long. You have to understand that we put all of that behind us. Project Purity, our work, all of it. We've moved on, even if your father hasn't. You mean you haven't? I assumed he sent you here. For that matter, aren't you supposed to be in a vault? James said he left you there. Did you? I was under the impression that's exactly the opposite of what he wanted for you. Well, you won't find him here. He's come and gone already. Your father insisted that we return to work on Project Purity. I tried telling him too much time has passed. There's no way it would work. Predictably, he refused to listen to me. He says he can prove it will work and headed off to the old lab. I'm sorry, I don't know what else to tell you. It's in the old Jefferson Memorial Building, northwest of here. Please, don't go after him. It was foolish of him to even think about going there alone. I suppose so. I worked with them for several years until your mother died and your father decided it was time to leave. What else do you want to know? James? He was very driven. Determined to change the world. Well, we all were back then, I suppose. He was focused on two things, really. Making Project Purity work, and your mother. When she died, I think he gave up. I know he wanted to keep you safe, but I think part of what he did was run away. But it seems that he never really was able to get over the idea. I'm frankly shocked that he waited all this time. And wants to try again. Yes, your mother was... Well, she was a good woman. A very dedicated scientist. Your father loved her very much. It was a shame that she died. She had been excited to meet you. Complications from childbirth. None of us were expecting it. We weren't as prepared as we could have been. You have to understand... We were struggling with scavenged, derelict equipment. We did everything we could. Yes. Well, I'm sorry it wasn't enough. Okay. Look, I don't want to be harsh, but I have problems of my own. I don't have the resources to support James's foolish endeavors or your chasing after him. I'm sorry. I'm sorry I am not in a position to help you. You understand, I have enough to worry about already. What? Well, I'm not sure what there is to tell. Your father and I, we worked together for a long time. I think we were really on to something. But then there were complications. The project was abandoned and your father disappeared. I returned here to Rivet City and established the lab you see before you now. Project Purity, we called it. What do you want to know? It was simple, really. Fresh, clean water for everyone. Such a simple idea, and yet so impossible to realize. The plan was to build a facility that could purify all the water in the tidal basin at once. No radiation, no muck, just clear water. It just turned out to be more difficult than we anticipated. We had the basic principles down, we understood most of the science behind it, but the radiation in the area is so pervasive. Small-scale tests were fine, but any time we tried to test the process on a larger scale, it was just too much. Maybe if we'd had more time, or better equipment. You happened. It wasn't just you. We had more problems than we could handle already, but your birth is what finally pushed it over the edge. Your father decided that you were more important than everything we'd been working for, and he left. He left all of us. Once he was gone, the Brotherhood decided we weren't worth their time anymore. Without their protection, we had to abandon the purifier. Okay. This is the Rivet City Science Lab. It's taken many long years to put together, but we've done well for ourselves. Our work on portable fusion power and hydroponics are coming along quite nicely, if not quite according to schedule. That idiot? He left so long ago, most folk don't even remember him. He claimed to have found a secret stash of technology somewhere in the ship. Then he just disappeared. Rivet City is one of the few bastions of civilization left in the land. We're working to rebuild our society, to make the world livable again. I could tell you all about the science lab, but even though I was here near the start, I can't really help with the details of how it all worked out. It all seems like a lifetime ago. I'm afraid I've had a lot of things on my mind since those early days. Good luck finding your father.
You won't tell me what's at stake. Vagaries and secrecy, a robot, Zimmer, no matter how shiny the paint job. Now, please.
Ignorance and facetiousness. That's all you people are good for. Shiny paint job indeed. You can't even imagine the Commonwealth's accomplishments.
You know, if you're so smart, maybe you could help us, hmm? But no, that never even crossed your mind. Go peddle your selfishness somewhere else.
Fine, but I'm not leaving. Not until I've spoken to Dr. Lee. I'll be here when she's ready to abandon her chemistry set and talk real science.
Suit yourself.
You there! What are you, some kind of lab assistant? No, you look a bit more weathered. Are you by any chance for hire? To the point! I like that. Well, as it turns out, I've misplaced some very sensitive property. How do I put this in a way you'll understand? All you know of robots are those buckets of bolts, those Mr. Handshakers and whatnot. Well, that's not all a robot can be. You see, in the Commonwealth, we've made artificial persons, synthetic humanoids, programmed to think and feel and do whatever we need. And occasionally, they get confused and wander off. Nonsense! This is a machine we're talking about. Can you enslave a generator or a water purifier? Of course not. The same principle applies. But let's get back to your mission. You are to find this missing android. I've tracked him to somewhere here in the capital wasteland. He must have done something drastic, like facial surgery and a mind wipe, or else I would have found him by now. It will be no easy task. He may not even realize he's an android. Don't upset him by talking with him. Just come get me immediately. I'll handle it. Of course! I have at my disposal advanced technology from the Commonwealth. I'd be willing to share some of it with you. Just think, you'll be the envy of all your friends. Excellent! Locate my android, and you won't be disappointed. Here, listen to this message he sent me. He's mocking me. I swear, I'll make him pay for that. Forget everything you know about robots. Those buckets are mere children's toys compared to the real thing. Androids have fake skin and blood and are programmed to simulate human behavior, like breathing. They can even eat and digest food realistically. Like I said, I suspect he's had facial reconstruction and possibly even a mind wipe. Search the offices of doctors or techies for android information. If he's come into contact with these people, there may be records. Start with Dr. Preston. He lives on this leaky boat. See if he knows anything. He's a doctor, after all. Now, if you'll excuse me, I'm busy trying to ignore my surroundings. Really? Someone managed to procure those here in the wasteland? Impressive! But who out here could have the skill to use them? You're making progress, certainly. But you've got nothing more to learn from me. Get back out there!
Hello.
The sooner you find my... The Commonwealth itself is nothing but a war-ravaged quagmire of violence and despair. Inside the sealed environment of the Institute, however. But the Institute's affairs are none of your concern. Your undeveloped mind couldn't even begin to comprehend what we've accomplished. A circuit neuralizer? Here in the wasteland? How'd they manage to get their grubby hands on one of those? Impressive. You are showing signs of intelligence and resourcefulness. You might turn out useful after all, but you're wasting time talking to me. Standing around all day looks to me like a giant boat ran aground and a bunch of savages moved in. History lesson over. Of course you do.
That's close enough. Keep your hands where I can see them.
What do you need? He's from up north. He was bragging about how great it is up there. Yeah, great. They can't even keep tabs on their robots. Later. Attention to what you're doing.
I'm looking for troublemakers, if you see any.
Quite an impressive collection, isn't it? Well, don't be shy. Have a look around. Abraham Washington's the name. Curator of this little slice of American history. Ah, a fellow scholar, I see. Each of the documents in this room tells a small but important story about the history of the United States of America. Unfortunately, the greatest prize of all is missing from the collection. In 1776, the Second Judgmental Congress got together and adopted a document drafted by none other than Thomas Jefferson himself. It was the day the United States of America earned its name and secured its place in history. This magnificent achievement took form in the Declaration of Independence. Oh, would you? It would mean so much to me and the Society's collection here. Excellent! You won't regret it, I promise you. Imagine, you are taking part in another chapter of American history. I envy you. You can find the Declaration of Independence in the ruins of the National Archives. In the DC ruins, you'll find the National Archives, or what's left of it anyway. The building should contain the document in a protective glass case. Be careful. The place is swarming with super mutants. Here, let me pinpoint its location for you. It's funny now that you ask. I can tell you all about the Capitol, but I really haven't got any idea about Rivet City itself. I can't see how important it is compared to the Capitol's history, but maybe Bannon might know something. He's in the Governing Council, after all. I hope next time I see you, the Declaration will be in hand. Yes, that's locked. And yes, I can see you eyeing it.
Everything looks okay here. Tamper with that, and we're going to have a problem.
Troublemaker. Have you seen any? I'm looking for Troublemaker. Have you seen any?
Hey there! You make it quick. I'm on a tight schedule. Yeah, he comes by every night around closing time and tries to get Cindy to let him close up. Thank God she's smarter than that. Bye.
May Saint Monica bless you. Yes, I know. I've been counseling him for some time now. He used to go stand on the observation balcony all afternoon. He's down to only an hour or so at 3 o'clock. Saint Monica bless you.
I'm looking for Troublemaker. Have you seen any?
Hey. It's locked for a reason. Get any ideas?
Hello, mister. I'm not supposed to talk to strangers.
Hey there. She's my daughter. You can usually find her running around with that James Hargrave. That poor child. His mother, Tammy Hargrave, is a very troubled woman. She spends too much time down in the Muddy Rudder, drinking and using foul language. I feel so sorry for him. I think CJ is a good influence on him, but I do worry about the two of them. We're the lucky ones. We don't have to fight just to survive. We have normal jobs. I clean the halls. It might not look like it, but you should have seen it before. Oh, I don't know about that. For all I know, it's had survivors on it since the war. I'm just thankful it's here. Maybe if you ask Bannon. He's been simply wonderful on the council, so I'm sure he'd be glad to help with your question. Goodbye.
This place could use a few more people willing to work. Everything is falling apart. I'm the only one willing to fix it. Hey there. That's secure for a reason.
Welcome to the Weatherly. Mr. Buckingham at your service. Oh, the mere 120 caps? Excellent. Simply venture into the hallway, turn left, first door on your left. That is your room. Or is that the broom closet? I always get those two mixed up. Yes, sir.
You need me? For what? So long.
Hey there!
You don't look hurt. What can I do for you? That was all just an elaborate hoax. I don't see anything wrong with you. Pinkerton, eh? That name takes me way back. Claimed to have cured radiation poisoning. Or was it food poisoning? I don't recall. He was always telling folks that he founded Rivet City. All he did was break off the front of it. Or did he die there? I don't recall. Don't get any cute ideas. Security is just a shout away. Now, if you've got any medical issues, let's hear them. Oh, I'd like to help. I really would. But I don't know the first thing about this place's history. Don't let my age fool you. I may have been around for a while, but I didn't spend all that time here. He's totally strung out. It's going to kill him one of these days. Take care of yourself.
Sir.
Welcome to the Weatherly Hotel. I'm your hostess, Vera Weatherly. Well, I really shouldn't tell you, but have you heard about Polly Cantelli? He's addicted to chems. His poor wife, Cindy, is at her wit's end. You haven't heard? Angela has the hots for Diego. But since he's a priest, he's been putting her off. One of these days, she's just going to jump his bones. Poor dear. I know what it's like to be alone. I'd love to take him in. Don't worry. I have the means to keep him fed and healthy, but most importantly, safe. Oh, that's wonderful. If you ever wander back into Rivet City, why don't you check up on us? You're always welcome. Hey, welcome back, sir. They say Mr. Lopez is losing it. He stands on the top of the bridge tower for hours at a time, just staring out over the city. She's not very social. Stays in her lab in the stern. She's smart, though. Real smart. Poor James. His mother drinks too much. When she does, she doesn't treat him very well. Personally, I think she blames him for his father leaving her, which is ridiculous. Well, I could tell you all about my hotel. But I'm sure I don't know anything about how Rivet City itself got started. I mean, you hear rumors and you make guesses, but I really couldn't say I know for sure. And I'd hate to lead you down the wrong path. Actually, now that you mention it, Seagrave may know more about it. He's been here since he was just a boy, and I can't imagine anyone knows this ship better than he does. Farewell. Hey.
Don't you have a component to deliver? Was there something else? You know what you need to do.
Hi, I'm Angela. My dad runs Gary's Galley. If you want anything to eat, talk to him. Dad and I have had a rough time, but we're getting by. James's mom, Tammy, is a real bitch. She treats him like crap. I think it's because she drinks too much. You mean like hitting on me? No. Most of them are polite. Even the ones like Diego that I'd want to flirt with seem to ignore me. Well, one of us is. Sometimes it seems like he doesn't even know I'm there. Especially if he is a priest with a thick skull. Well, I'm not giving up. I just know we're made for each other. I heard the place was settled by mercenaries who used to scavenge DC, but I don't really know. Later.
Goodness, I'm on duty. Make it quick.
Don't tell me your problems.
Have a seat anywhere. Someone will be with you in a minute.
Yeah, Belle's gonna have to replace some tables and chairs. I'm sure she'll just scrounge some from the lower deck. Welcome to a quick fix. Don't mind me.
Is there a problem? Bannon and Dr. Lee and I all meet on Monday mornings to talk about citywide issues. It's pretty informal. The Council doesn't have much real power. Carry on, then.
That's secure for a reason.
Thank you, Cindy.
Howdy, I'm Seagrave. Seagrave Holmes. I have a little of just about everything here. I've got a little bit of everything. Oh, I really wouldn't know. I mean, long as I can remember, she's just been here, soaking up all the repairs and attention we can give her. I grabbed a wrench and joined in the reconstruction pretty much first thing out of the womb, but I never really cared about the politics. Last feller I remember from back then was Mr. Pinkerton. And he must have left about a decade ago, after that spat with the science team. He used to have a storage shed in the broken-off bow of the ship. We always thought he was crazy for keeping stuff there. Might have kept a couple records down there, I guess. Careful, though. Ship's a bit treacherous down there in her belly. She did? Well, I suppose I've picked up a lot over the years. I mean, no one's spent more time tinkering on this old girl than I have. Oh, Rivet City, I mean. Not Vera. I mean, Vera's not old. And I haven't tinkered on her, obviously. Not that I wouldn't. I mean, no. Anyway, you might find some clues in Pinkerton's place, in the broken-off bow. He was around before me and used to store stuff there before he left. Oh, well, the old girl had seen a lot of damage, especially where the Mirelurks used to nest, and where the super mutants kept trying to get in. I guess the mutants and the Myers got so busy fighting each other, it gave us the time we needed to make this place shipshape. Does that tell you what you need to know? Anyway, we're here in Rivet City, and she's in good hands now. Oh, right. I sort of lose track of time talking about the old girl. See you later.
Let me or a security officer know if you see anything out of the ordinary.
Don't mind me, mister.
Hello.
Any problems in the muddy rudder that I should know about?
No, I haven't seen anything.
Yes?
Hey, don't you have a component to deliver?
Don't even think of breaking into that.
Welcome to Potomac Attire. I am Bannon, proprietor and city council member. I carry discriminating attire for discriminating customers. Straight to the point. I like that. Now, there's a name I haven't heard in a while. Never met the man myself, but rumor has it he helped found Rivet City. Some rumors say he died trying to loot the broken bow of the ship. Others say he joined up with the Enclave. Dr. Lee, Chief Harkness, and I are all on the council. We meet every Monday morning. I can be very influential, if you know what I mean. Far more than Seagrave Holmes. So you've met him, eh? Well, he wants to replace me on the council. Now, I can't have that. No, siree. He's a shady character, I just can't prove it. If someone were to find something incriminating in his room, well, let's just say I would be very appreciative. Dr. Lee, Chief Harkness, and I are all on the council. We meet every Monday morning. I can be very influential, if you know what I mean. Disgusting, isn't it?
Someone should talk to that boy. He has no business hanging around that tramp if he's going to be a priest. Come back soon.
I'm gonna go play with James.
Zimmer, by the time you get this message, I'll already be gone. I'm escaping the Commonwealth. I want to live my own life on my own terms, as my own man. I know what you're thinking, that I'm malfunctioning. I used to think that's what caused the runaways too. But I know better now. Self-determination is not a malfunction. I'm not just willing to put up with all the bullshit anymore. You humans are going to have a full-fledged rebellion on your hands if you don't start treating us synths as persons. I know you'll be marshalling the Retention Bureau to come after me, but I know all the tricks of the trade. You won't be finding me, I assure you. By the time you get this, I will be someone else. It's the price I pay for my liberation. My final act of rebellion against a system I no longer believe in. Goodbye, Zimmer, and good riddance.
Anyone who can hear me, my name is Werner. I come from a settlement to the north.
This is a high priority.
Hello.
That's secure for a reason.
Yes.
Hey there. Tamper with that, and we're going to have a problem. Good to see you. some sort of... battle in the city yesterday. The gate... guard said that the... gunfire went off. Over an hour.
That's why I'm glad I'm in here. Good old Rivet City.
Me too. Nothing is getting through these walls.
There was some sort of battle in the city yesterday. The gate guard said the gunfire went on for over an hour.
That's why I'm glad I'm in here. Good old Rivet City.
Me too. Nothing is getting through these walls.
Good to see you.
I'm Diego, the acolyte for St. Monica's. Oh yes, Father Clifford conducts services every Sunday morning. You should come. What are you talking about? I'm a man of the cloth. Well, I will be as soon as Father Clifford... Never mind. It doesn't matter what Angela thinks. Soon I will take vows of chastity. Father Clifford says she is my trial, my temptation. I must choose between her and the church. I have chosen the church. God bless you.
I need to move on to the mid-deck. Hey there.
I'm looking for troublemakers. Have you seen any? Everything looks okay here.
Buy a girl a drink, sailor? Tightwad?
Welcome to Potomac Attire. I think I've seen you in here before. When you're ready to buy, just let me know. Why, I practically set this whole place up. Well, yes, but it was hardly any place of importance until I arrived on the scene. That's all ancient history now. No one would ever care about it. If you insist on wasting your time on that, you could try that bartending old crone down below, Belle Bonnie. Come back soon.
You're a petty criminal, but I'm willing to give you another chance. Don't disappoint me.